Stay. Come. Sloan, free. Sit.
Good girl.
Touch. 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 Down. So the down we have to also point down and then point. Sometimes you have to point where it becomes below the, her chin. So your hand is level and or below her chin for her to go into a down with the hand gesture. But I am teaching her also how to do it by verbalization. She just hasn't picked it up as well as she has with her hand gesture.
Sloan, come. Touch.
Good girl. Yes, you are. You're smarty.
Touch. Touch.
Where are you going? There you go. So you may notice where my hand is relative to her head. Sloan. Down. I'm sorry, it's taking too long. Stay. Like traffic stop. Traffic hand stop. Stay. No. I know, we've only really been practicing in the hallway and down and outside. Stay. If she does get up from a stay, you don't say anything. You just, you know, you have to redo it.
Free, come.
You are such a good girl. Yes, you are. There you go.
Touch.
I'm just doing the mouth click just to kind of show her exactly why she got the treat. That's that nose touch.
Touch. Touch, touch, touch.
You keep forgetting you want to go in straight into this room. There you go.
All right, let's go.
Down. Down. The reason I'm not doing the hand gesture is I'm trying to get her to understand the verbalization. But now I will. Down. So see, she does it better with the hand gesture if the hand is below her chin level.
Touch.
Run day. And anytime you're giving out free treats, you can just say their names right before you give it to them, just to kind of establish the importance of their name and attention. Down. So because she moved, I'm going to say it again, just the verbal. I'll give her a treat because I want her to realize that this is a correct answer and that she can give it to me or try to give it to me later on.
Rande.
Later on, I'm only going to be pairing food with when she performs the behavior when I ask for it, not just when she offers it.
Sit.
Now Now, if she moves when I say down, that's when I'm not just going to throw her the arm. I'm going to throw, say it again. Down. So this time, since she didn't move, down, and then the hand. So this is how she's going to learn the word. You may say it, and then give it a second. If she doesn't perform, wait a couple more seconds, then say it, and a second later, perform the hand. So I'll show how that looks again. Sloan, touch. She has a pretty good default SIT, so she'll just go into it. For she has a very specific place that she likes to be when she's working.
Sloan, come here.
Good girl. Down. Down. And then the hand.
You're silly.
So she doesn't perform. We'll just do it again. Down. You wait a beat. Then the hand. So she really understands the hand gesture. She's still learning what the verbalization means. I'm sorry, sweetie. I'm like down to crumbs. So she's understanding the hand gesture. We just got to transfer the cue to the word. And so that's how we do it. We say the word, then followed by a second, 2 second gap, and then we throw the hand. And over time, she's going to start to realize, hi, sweetie, she's going to start to realize that the word means the same as the hand gesture. So she's going to start performing the behavior with just the word too. Rande is about the same. She understands the hand gesture a little better, but they're both throwing the down out randomly. And I am still treating them for that because I want them to, rather than just stand up and pace around and get another sit in, rather than, you know, if they're hesitant and don't understand why they're not getting a treat, to throw out a down, which is a lot better than vocalizing, pawing, jumping. So when in doubt, sit. When still in doubt, lay down. When really in doubt, sing. Good girls. Yes, you are.